Everyone, welcome back to Pokémon Master EX. We are here, of course, for a very big celebration, the 3.5 year anniversary of the game. It has been a really long while since the start of Pokémon Master EX, and finally we are at a very cool point into the game cycle. Today we have three characters from Galar, but I am only after one, and I will tell you why while we do the gacha, which is, of course, Marnie. I have all the Marnies. I have Summer Marnie, I have Palantine Marnie, I have the normal one, which is technically Apocryphaire. I have all of them, even the Lodge one. So, it stands to reason that I also want the one that actually also has a very big gameplay value to me, because my Dark Team is pretty much non-existent. It is really bad, one of my worst types together with Ice and Bug. So getting Marnie is actually a very good thing to do for me, both because I like the character and because she's actually quite crazy in her own type. So, today we are here to celebrate, we are here to roll the gacha, we are here to get the freebie champion character that they are giving out, and I will tell you guys which one is the best for veterans and newbies alike according to myself, and then whatever else happens, because if we get add-on of Marnie's, I want to try to at least get 3 copies if I can, but generally speaking this is a master sync per gacha. In the past those have been quite ruthless to me. We have the Signa Suit Serena, which took all of my gems and had to spark. Renegade Cynthia took all my gems and had to spark. Anniversary Lily took all my gems and had to spark. The triple Yodo master sync per, let's not even talk about that for how poorly it went, at least we got Lyra. Well, today we hope that this does not happen and actually we get multiple copies of Marnie. If that happens, I will be very happy. If it doesn't, well, it is what it is. A couple of things to remember before we dive deep into it. You guys will be given a ton of free gems, 3,000 from the direct yesterday and 1,000 per day, plus all the freebies. Tickets, temple tickets, etc. So you do want to get them. Make sure to get them, because this is probably a worthwhile time to log in, at least until the celebration ends. Then after that you can take a break a little bit, etc. But you do want to get the gems right now. The Kalos Villain Arc celebrations are also still ongoing, so if you want to get upgrades for Sigamore and other characters from the Kalos region, remember that you can get them right now. It ends, I believe, in a few days, yes. So do it, because Sigamore is actually a very very good support to get, even if you are new, since he is free, after all. And then, for the Lodge, we actually have a very cool update. As you can see, you can set a piece of artwork as the loading screen, and you can get what I like to call decorations. As you can see, I set up 3 dolls, Serena Sat, Elisa headphones, and then some random trophies that I will rotate out as soon as I get other things. Pretty cool. Then you can set photos, artworks, etc. To give you guys an example, I bought, I believe, 2 artworks, and you can even change the style of the place. I took the noble style because I think that it is quite cool. Anyway, they are making sure that the Lodge is very customizable, which is a cool thing for sure. Dawn, and soon enough we will also get Gloria. I will try to get those Lodge stories out, and then I promise I will do my best to start on the Mels. The Lodge stuff is actually quite forgettable for me to do, because I forget about it to do it daily, so sometimes you will have to apologize, I can be quite slow. Ok, that's it for the update. We have some more cool stuff, but I will leave it to you to discover in the game. Let's go into the gacha, shall we? So we have 3 characters, as I told you, Marnie, Hop and Bede, coming in this order. The first one is of course Marnie. She is a Strike Dark type with a Body Move and also the Master Sync per bonus. So you can see the usual Master Sync per stuff, tickets, coins, etc., which I really love. You want to get Marnie for one simple reason. She's actually not like Ash, but very close to being Ash levels of incredibly good for her own type, which in this case is Dark. Dark is a type that doesn't really have that strong of DPS. She does a ton of very valuable supports, tanks, and sort of niche stuff, but someone like Marnie, he didn't have it, so That's why I want to gather primarily. Hope is fighting, which is sort of overcrowded with good sync pairs like Aura Cynthia, we have Bea, we have what's her name? Gloria, there are a ton of very good fighting sync pairs. Bede, I'm not really sure if he's Ice or Psychic, but for Psychic there are a ton of really good ones as well. For Ice, he could be kinda decent, but from what I saw he's more of a mixed support with nothing really that makes him a must get for what is the current meta of terrain plus heavy DPS. So to me, I want to get Marnie, that's mainly what I want to say. Let's get into it and see if that feeling is also shared by the character that so far I managed to get every single time. So if I am blessed by Marnie and get her now as well, then that's probably a good sign that I will have to try and roll Ergashas into the future as well, but I don't think that she's getting anything anytime soon. Okay, first pool 5 star, we have... what's his name, actually? Oh, I actually forgot. It's not How is the rival? I'm not really sure who it is, then I will remember the name. Dawn, of course, I remember. Candice, we have the twins, yes, those characters I remember. What's the name of that guy? Marowak and... not... it doesn't start with T. Now I have to click it to remember. I don't want to know about the power up. Damn it. Now you will leave me with the doubt of who this character is, won't you, Pokémon Master? Damn you. Okay, first pool, we then get more 5 stars. Not Tierno. Tierno is the guy from Kalos. I'm still thinking about it because it is really someone that I have the name on the tip of my tongue, but. Marowak, Mallow, Suiren, and. Damn it. Why can't I remember it? It is probably a very simple name, that's why I'm forgetting it. Kiawe, there we go. It came to me. My memory didn't fail me. Okay, let's resume the gacha. So far it doesn't look like we are delving into some good early pools. We did get some free tickets. Those are always nice to get, especially for someone that does a lot of showcases like me. But I kinda want to get Marnie. As soon as we get Marnie, I will be reassured. I will say, ah, okay, very nice. Then if we get actually many copies of Marnie, I will switch and try to get Emma. Emma is a character from Kalos, which I actually really want to get because she makes my investment for Halloween Iris worthwhile, because she's an incredible good poison type, and also I like the character. The Kalos villain arc has been quite interesting because it isn't focused around the Kalos group, it focused around the Kalos, not the secondary cast, but let's say the detective cast, which is an interesting decision for sure. So far the villain arc have mostly focused around the rivals and or the protagonist, so that's an interesting switch of story type. Also we see that the Neo Champions are pretty much becoming the new limited that will replace the Master Sync Pairs into the future, since they get their own event, their own artwork, they are so big to become the anniversary celebrations. And it seems like the team for the new champions is Rivals, because we had Serena and Kalem, which are the rivals of X and Y, depending on which of the two you choose as your main character. And then we have the rivals of Sword and Shield, which are Marnie... Oh, wait! Is it there? Yes! Yes, yes, yes! I really love the fact that they did the sync pair that I actually thought fit Marnie the best. Her and Galadriel Moltres. Galadriel Moltres is basically Team Yell represented into a character, a legendary in this case. So I do think that it fits her really really well. And the dress in this case, much like Serena, seems to follow a princess, prince sort of style in terms of champion design. I think that she rocks it very well. The alternative I saw it is in pink, which actually will keep because it looks also very well, but I might switch between the two because I do think black fits her hair better, and also the slight dash of red slash pink on her dress is better, but we'll see both of them together and probably I will do like I did with Serena, where I put the one that I prefer on the top. Serena thought that I get the dark one because she has blue and dark. Serena looked better with the dark one. Generally, I like in clothes black is a better color for many reasons, especially if you want to keep, let's say, better look of your stomach hidden, etc. It is a good color to have. Okay, let's see if we can get another money or if I have to let up of my luck. Of course, doing this one is always a good choice. You get 3 candies, not 3 candies, I wish. 3 coins, which are always pretty good to have as a sort of extra prize from those gachas. So let's see if it holds up. Okay, no, doesn't look like we got another money here. But at least the fact that we got one, my friends, is actually pretty big. Remember, this is one of the hardest gachas, if not the hardest in the game. One that makes my skin crawl every day because of how hard it is. Let's do a skip here. Let's see if we are lucky. Come on. Okay, no, we have Berta. Actually, is it my first Berta? No, second Berta. Okay, so let me check something. I want to see if I actually have enough candies for Marnie. So we go upgrades. This is the fastest way to do it, actually. It takes a long time to load in because I have basically a ton of sync pairs, as you can see. And a ton of them are also being upgraded to the max. So let's see, move level, I only have one, I want to get 2, that's the problem here, but I do think that actually I have the necessary amount of coins to trade. Let me see, so we got 2 coins from the gacha that I still haven't redeemed. Let's see if I have enough. No, okay, so we actually do have to try and get Marnie here. Ah! This will be tough, really tough, but we will try, we will try. Come on, Marnie, just one more. One more. Do this for us. Does it look like this one is the bull? However, let's see another one. Come on. Ok, ok, good start. Come on, just one more. This is Volkner, not what we want. Ah, you know, now I'm kinda disheartened because if it is 1 coin I can farm it, but I kinda also wanted to get it right now. Let's just be honest here and go for what we want. I want to try and get Emma with the few pulls that I have left, just to see if I am lucky enough to get it. Let's see. Okay. Come on, if we get Emma, I will go back and get Marnie and more copies. Ok, so let's let this one wind out. Sometimes it is better to let the gacha do its course. Come on, usually with Pokéfers I'm pretty lucky, so I'm not too worried about this. Ok, we have Winona, I believe. Actually, I remember so many Pokémon names, I'm surprised that I have such a strong memory for their names. Generally, I forget the character names so fast for whatever reason. Another Berta, what is with her? It's not that I am mad about it, because she's actually kinda good for, I believe she's a ground tank or something crazy like that. But I would love to get the on-banner characters if we can. Okay, last one for Emma, let's see if she's going to join us or not. Let's let this one wind down. Come on, Emma. Leave this gacha into a very positive outlook, because we got the Master Sync Pair, which I will upgrade with coins, since I'm not really going to risk it and go all in on the banner. I will use my remaining gems to save up for whatever comes next month. Usually the Easter Sync Pairs are pretty fun. Oh, wait, we got an Helio that I skipped, not bad. Okay, doesn't look like we got them, however. Okay, that's fine, that's fine. So we have how many scout points on Marnie? Half. We actually got pretty lucky, I will say. So right now I want to show you guys about the ticket. There we go. Once again the word failed me. So for the champion ticket this year you have 6 choices. You have... Let's see. Steven, Cynthia, Iris, Alt, so alternate, before it was champions, now we change into alternate, I guess. Lance, Alder, and Ayanta. So let's split the two decisions. If you are new and if you are a veteran. So if you are a veteran, generally speaking, you probably have Cynthia, Iris, Lance, and Ayanta. Those are generally the four that I've seen the most. Steven and Alder, it is kind of hard because Steven, I believe, came right before or right after an anniversary. So not many rolled on him, but many got him for free from the champion ticket, all the same. While Alder also was kind of unpopular, even though he's actually fairly good in his own time, which is a bug. So if you are new, you have none of those characters since they are all Pokéfairs. Which one do you want? So right here, I will suggest two choices depending on what you want to go for. The first one is Iris. Iris is a very strong tech type with a support added into her, which lowers the attack or special attack of the enemies. This might seem sort of an average effect, but she does it away, and it helps a lot into bridging yourself into difficult modes, because you lower the attack, your Pokémon, which might be lower rarities, etc., can tank the hits, and so it is a lot better in comparison to what you can do without her. The second character that I would suggest is Cynthia. She got a new grid. She's actually really strong for ground, even though there are way better upgrades, but most of those are also limited. And in general, she works very well with add-on of easy to access Sync Pearls from the Gacha, which you can get pretty easily. The other four are not bad, but for a new player, those two are the ones that I will call very valuable. If you are a veteran, instead, I will try to get yourself Alder, because he is a bug type, those are very rare. He actually does quite well into the bug type, and I do believe if he hasn't already that he got a grid update, so he actually is better than ever. So to me, who am I going to get? I'm going to get Alder, because I do not have him. Or actually, is it random? Ah, it is random, okay. So forget what I said, just get who you want. Who do we get? Ah no, it's not random, okay. I am so dumb sometimes because I don't read the stuff. It was just an 11 pull and then you choose. Okay, so I was right. So I can choose between Steven, which is a steel, and actually have one of the craziest steel teams. Gloria plus Marnie plus Hop. It is insanely good. I will get myself an Alder. Since I do not have a good bug sync pair, Alder is actually a pretty good bug sync pair. And now my bug team is very happy about this. Let's see it. And there we go, Alder and Volcarona, a Pokémon that I actually quite like, so I'm happy that we got him. Also remember that you have the free 10 pulls that you get daily, up to a maximum of 100. Let's see if we get anyone, but not been too lucky with this one actually, so not anyone at all, okay, that's fine. So, before we go away, the traditional upgrade time for Marnie in this case. Hoping that I actually have all for the level cap. I do not, but whatever. I will get it off video. It is fine most of the time. I don't have the last 5 levels for whatever reason. Remember, as usual, get your custom power-ups first. It is actually pretty important to keep the tickets whenever you can. Move level, we actually will do that off video, but it is fine. Let's see the alternate EX dress over here. Come on! Oh, ok. So actually didn't remember that she had the black on the bottom. So now I'm actually done because I actually like them really much both the same. But I don't think that the black is better. No, I will keep the black. I really like the black. I think it is actually pretty good for what it is. Ok, my friends. So I will do Marnie and their EX showcase next, of course. Last time we did, I believe I uploaded Hilda, which I did a long time ago actually, but finally got around to getting it together. After Marnie, who will I do? Well, we have actually quite a ton of Sync Pass that I haven't gone through right now. In my opinion, the one that I want to do the most currently are some that I have upgraded in the past, like Signasuit Steven, I want to do for sure. Then let's see it, who else? Ah, yes. what's her name, Courtney, which I also have already recorded. I just need to put it in the channel. And this girl over here, Kali, the Fury Sword girl from the New Year's. Those are the three next that I want to do. So you will see them very soon. Anyway, my friends, it has been a long gacha, but it is an anniversary, so I wanted to catch up with you guys. As usual, you will see probably the event and then the showcase, if not the showcase and then the event, we will see. But you will see those in the coming days for sure. Best of luck if you are going for Marnie, Bede or Hop, whichever you want. I will give you guys my piece on Marnie on the showcase, the rest I already told you about. Just roll for who you like, that's the best advice that I can give you. I will see you next time for the gacha next month probably. I'm not going to roll anything else this month because of the fact that we might get Isui very soon and I'm waiting to get Isui, so I am really stern on that. But we got Marnie and I really like Marnie, so I went all in on her, but that's it for now. I will have to wait and save up. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, my friends. I will see you next time. Remember to like and a sub to support the channel, and to support the channel even more, you can always use the Super Thanks feature to leave a comment with the nation you are choosing below your favorite Pokémon Master EX videos. Best of luck to you all, and have fun with the new anniversary and new features that are in the game. Bye, my friends!